Everyone, in continuation to our neoplasia series, this is our sixth video. In the fifth video, we have clearly dealt with the carcinogenesis. So the questions like chemical carcinogenesis, radiation carcinogenesis, viral carcinogenesis, the prerequisite and the must write topic that should be mentioned in every answer, this is carcinogenesis. So if you have missed out our fifth video, just go through it once for sure. Now, what is carcinogen? Carcinogen is an agent that is causing the genetic damage or neoplastic transformation of a cell. Okay, so what is a carcinogen? It is going to cause a genetic damage and neoplastic transformation of a normal cell. जीन्स का डैमेज करके एक नॉर्मल सेल का अगर वो जेनेटिक नियोप्लास्टिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन कर रहा है तो उसको आप कार्सिनोजन का नाम देते हैं. नाउ द क्वेश्चन विच यू आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टूडे इज योर केमिकल कार्सिनोजेनेसिस विच इज़ अ पोटेंशियल क्वेश्चन फॉर 5 marker और 6 marker क्वेश्चन. राइट, सी यू नो दैट केमिकल कार्सिनोजन्स इफ वी स्पेसिफिकली टॉक, सो दे how they are going to progress, let us first understand. See, the chemicals either they will be directly acting chemicals or there will be indirectly acting chemicals. Okay, now what does this mean? See, if a chemical is directly acting on the cell and is converting the cell or the gene into a carcinogen, that is a directly acting. But for example, if it is present but it needs a metabolical activation to become a carcinogen, okay, or to change the cell into a potentiated carcinogen, then we call it as a indirectly acting chemical. Okay, now just remember how it is going to proceed. You have something known as procarcinogen that is present inside our body only. Okay, the smoke is going to convert that procarcinogen into a carcinogen with the help of P450. So you know that the chemicals which are present in smoke, these are indirectly acting. These are indirectly acting. Okay, now once it is converted into a carcinogen, the carcinogen means what? Means it has the probability to cause the cancer. Okay, so the carcinogen substance is going to come in contact with some promoting agents, that will be responsible for the mutations in the DNA that are caused by the carcinogen. Okay, samajh mein aaya? For example, mera chori karne ka man tha, so that is a carcinogen. उसके साथ ही क्या हुआ, मैं बहुत बड़े लॉस में चला गया, तो दैट इज़ अ प्रोमोटिंग रीजन, दैट इज़ अ प्रोमोशन. ओके, और उसके बाद मैंने चोरी की, दैट इज़ अ डीएनए म्यूटेशन. फाइन, समझ में आ गया. सो दिस इज समथिंग केमिकल कार्सिनोजेनेसिस, लाइक देयर इज़ अ इनिशिएशन, दैट मीन्स अ डायरेक्टली एक्टिंग और इनडायरेक्टली एक्टिंग केमिकल इज गोइंग टू फॉर्म अ कार्सिनोजन सब्सटेंस. नेक्स्ट इज योर प्रोमोशन, दैट मीन्स द कार्सिनोजन सब्सटेंस इज गोइंग टू कॉज अ डीएनए म्यूटेशन. ओके, समझ में आया. एंड लेटर द थर्ड स्टेज इज प्रोग्रेशन. ओके, देन देयर विल बी अ प्रोग्रेशन ऑफ द डिजीज. ओके, हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू प्रोग्रेस, दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन आवर फिफ्थ वीडियो. ओके, नाउ लेट अस सी द इनिशिएशन इन अ बिट मोर डिटेल. इनिशिएशन मीन्स व्हाट? आई टोल्ड यू दैट देयर विल बी अ केमिकल कार्सिनोजन. ओके, डायरेक्टली एक्टिंग और इनडायरेक्टली एक्टिंग कार्सिनोजन. ओके, नाउ दिस कार्सिनोजन is going to form some electrophilic intermediates. Mostly the carcinogen and the electrophilic intermediates is going to detoxify and then excreted out of the body. But if the electrophilic intermediate is going to bind to the DNA, it is going to form an adductor. यानी कि electrophile जो intermediate था उसने DNA को bind कर लिया, adduct formation हो गया. तब भी दो चांसेस हैं बचने के, या तो डीएनए रिपेयर हो जाए या फिर पूरा का पूरा सेल ही मर जाए. अगर सेल मर गया तो वो डिवाइड नहीं कर पाएगा, दैट मीन्स द म्यूटेशन विच हैज बीन इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इनटू द डीएनए इज नो लॉन्गर गोइंग टू पास फ्रॉम वन सेल टू अनदर. ठीक है, सेल ही मर गया तो क्या डिवाइड करेगा, क्या म्यूटेशन ट्रांसफर होगी, कुछ भी नहीं होगा. बट इफ द डीएनए अडक्ट फॉर्मेशन इज गोइंग टू एंड अप इनटू अ परमानेंट डीएनए लीजन, ठीक है, डीएनए का परमानेंट लीजन हो गया. रिमेंबर हेयर इट इज एन इनिशिएटेड सेल, एक इनिशिएटेड सेल आ चुका है दैट इज गोइंग टू कॉज फर्दर डीएनए म्यूटेशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ समथिंग नोन एज प्रोमोटर्स. एंड द डीएनए म्यूटेशन, the mutations which has been caused in the DNA, they are going to form a neoplasm, and further they are going to cause the malignancy, right? So this is the proper sequence, fine, initiation, right? And we must know what are the different agents which are responsible for causing the initiation. See, initiations, I told you, by the directly acting agents. Now, what are the different directly acting agents? First one is your alkylating agent. Another one is your acylating agents. Okay, alkylating agents and acylating agents. Okay, but in indirectly acting means it requires what? It requires cytochrome P450 to convert the procarcinogen into carcinogen. You have something, some examples like polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, for example, benz anthracene, fossil fuels, which is responsible for causing lung and skin cancer, then aflatoxin, responsible for causing HCC, hepatocellular carcinoma, betel nuts, kehte hai na? नट्स, सुपारी वगैरह खाने से ओरल कैंसर होता है, दिस इज इनडायरेक्टली एक्टिंग. विनाइल क्लोराइड, इट इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉजिंग हेपेटिक एंजियोसार्कोमा. एस्बेस्टॉस, रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉजिंग लंग कैंसर्स. ओके, सो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रिमेंबर दीज विद द हेल्प ऑफ अ निमोनिक, यू हैव समथिंग नोन एज वो फैप. ओके, आई होप दैट यू नो द मीनिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड. एनीवेज, वो फैप, वी फॉर विनाइल क्लोराइड, ओ फॉर oral cancers caused by the betel nuts, F for fossils, A for asbestos, then aflatoxins, and polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons. Okay, now I told you indirectly acting you have alkylating and acylating agents. So alkylating agents are these and acylating agents are these. So what I would like to tell you to remember is this is almost common: dimethyl carbamyl chloride, dimethyl sulfate. Okay, so the sulfate one is in your alkylating, and dimethyl carbamyl, see, from this C you can remember this C, the acylating agent. Okay, carbamyl, dimethyl carbamyl chloride. Okay, there are some anti-cancerous drug also, like for example cyclophosphamide is an anti-cancer drug, but my dear friends, it is itself a directly acting carcinogen. Okay, so these one two things you must remember. Okay, now you have something known as promoters. You have some examples like phenols, some hormones, right? For example, if you have a breast cancer, in this breast cancer, the progesterone, the estrogen, right, these are very important hormones which further complicate your breast cancer, right? Then there was a study which was done by the famous scientists. What they have done, see, in this star mark is your initiators ka apply karna, and this triangle is your promoter ka apply karna. Agar aap sirf initiator dete hain, there is no tumor. Agar aap initiator dete hain and promoter dete hain, there is a tumor. Initiator dene ke kuch samay ke baad promoter dete hain, again tumor is there. Then pehle promoter diya, baad mein initiator diya, there is nothing going to happen. Okay, and only you are applying your promoter, nothing is going to happen. You are giving initiator, giving nothing, giving promoter, then nothing, then promoter, then nothing. So there is a no tumor which is going to happen. So this was all about your chemical carcinogenesis. Thank you so much for watching.